Hello, everyone, and welcome to Live Talk. I'm Mike.
I'm Rainbow. What is going on with you today?
Oh, did you notice?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Are you trying a new look?
I am. It's my new look for the fall.
Oh my gosh.
It's the new me. You can still call me Mike, but I have a whole new stylish attitude.
So this was a perm and like some dyeing?
I was at the hairdresser for 3 days.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. That's a lot of days.
3 days. There was a team of 14 people working on me to make me look this fabulous.
How do you feel about it?
Wonderful. Why wouldn't I? Look at me. I look like a $1 billion.
Wow. Yeah. I think we gotta get you back to another hair salon. I have one I would recommend you to go to because this one is a little bit off.
Are you saying you can make this better?
Yeah. Oh. You wanna try?
Yeah, okay.
Okay.
What color?
How about gold next time?
Gold.
Oh, ooh. Silver or gray.
Silver gray. Ooh, I like that. Can I have gold, silver, and gray?
Maybe, because this is a bit too white.
Can I have bronze, silver, and gold like the Olympics?
We can try.
I could do Olympics hair.
Okay.
We'll do that.
It'll just take you 3 more days.
Okay.
Okay, let's go now.
Let's have a hair salon experience.
A hairdresser wraps a salon cape around Aubrey.
Same as last time?
I liked what you did last time, but I feel like doing something different.
Nice. It's just that a long bob cut might not be right for your face shape. I think a pixie cut would look good on you, but it would be a big change, obviously.
I'm not sure if I'm ready for something like that. Maybe I'll just get the usual today.
Of course.
All right, so yes, we are having a hair salon experience. I guess my experience didn't really work out.
Oh, I'm so glad you got it back.
Yeah, well, this took a lot of work, too. Did.
Really?
Days.
Really?
Thousands of dollars to make this come true.
Wow.
Yeah.
Wow.
Anyway, let's get into our dialogue. Part one is called a hip look. Now when we talk about a hip look, we're not talking about this part of your body. This is your hip, right? These are your hips where your legs join your body. No, here hip is kind of like cool and fashionable and stylish.
Yeah.
If you're always wearing the latest styles and know about the coolest things, people might say, hey, you're really hip. You're really in style. So a hip look, a stylish, fashionable look. And it says a hairdresser wraps a salon cape around Aubrey. Oh, that thing that they make you wear so the hair doesn't get all over your clothes. Yeah, sure. And they're going to wrap it around the lady who's paying to get her hair done. Her name is Aubrey. When you wrap something, you basically put something soft around another thing. The thing I always think of when I read this is either wrapping presents in colorful paper like you do at Christmas or for a birthday, or you might wrap something around food before you put it in the fridge, right?
Yeah.
Like plastic stuff or that metal stuff. It's not like hard, you're not putting it in a box. No, you're kind of putting things around it. You might wrap a towel around your hair.
Yeah, definitely.
After you wash it.
Exactly.
Right?
So just like the sentence, Rosita wrapped a towel around her wet hair. And you keep it in for like 10 minutes and then you dry it and it's a lot easier.
There you go. So as we begin the dialogue, the stylist says,
same as last time? Oh. Okay, so this is a regular stylist that Aubrey goes to, and the hairstylist knows her really well, so she's saying, do you want the same haircut as last time, or should we try something else?
Exactly, and that is the kind of thing you would get asked when you're at the stylist or at the salon that you go to most often. And Aubrey actually has a bit of an idea. Aubrey says, I liked what you did last time, but I feel like doing something different.
Interesting.
Oh, okay, so maybe not the same as last time. And then we read in the dialogue, Aubrey shows the hairdresser a picture on her cell phone.
Oh, I do that too.
So there's maybe a famous picture, movie star, yeah. a fashion model she saw in a magazine or on a website. And she's like,
I
kind of like that one. Can you do that one? And what does the hairstylist think of this idea?
The hairstylist is nice. It's just that a long bob cut might not be right for your face shape. This is a really good consideration because when we like how other people look, we sometimes don't know that we have a different shape. So the same cut might not look good on us. So we need professional advice. So the hairstylist says, I think a pixie cut would look good on you. So a long bob is like long and then straight on the bottom. Pixie is kind of like mine, a little bit round. So I think that is because this Aubrey girl has a different face shape. So then the hairstyle says, but it would be a big change, obviously. Not everybody wants to have a short pixie cut. Shorter would be like this and going in. And I think that's huge change for any girl.
Absolutely. Especially if your hair is quite long.
Yeah.
Having it suddenly a very sort of boyish short kind of length.
Yeah.
That is a big change. So yeah, obviously that's something you need to think about. And when we use this word obviously, this is an adverb that just sort of means it's clear to be seen. It's easy to understand. I'm saying it, but I probably don't have to. I certainly don't have to explain it. This is something that anyone can figure out. Here's a good example. Oh, obviously the chicken has gone bad, you know?
Ew.
You can smell it in the whole kitchen. You really don't have to think, when did I buy the chicken?
Ew.
No, clearly it's green, it has things growing on it,
ew.
And it makes the whole house smell like bad chicken. So obviously the chicken is bad. There's no question here.
Yeah, and sometimes when somebody asks you a question and you really feel like, yeah, this is definitely right, sometimes people say, yeah, obviously.
For sure.
For sure, of course. Okay, so then Aubrey says, I'm not sure if I'm ready for something like that.
A big change, yeah.
Yeah, it's maybe too short. So Aubrey says, maybe I'll just get the usual today. She's not so ready to suddenly make a big change.
All right, well, at least the hairstylist kind of gave her some things to think about. And so the hairstylist, as we wrap up, says, of course, sure. I think this happens a lot, right? There's a new hairstyle, maybe a famous person's got it. It looks really good on them, but sometimes, you know, the shape of your face or the kind of hair you have, it can make it hard, right?
Yeah.
So it's good for hairstylists to kind of tell people a few of the things they might not think about. It could be kind of disappointing for Aubrey. She had this idea that she'll look so good like this movie star, but maybe she won't look so good. So the hairstylist did a good job there of explaining the situation. And where our situation is, it's time for a break. So let's do that. And then we'll be back with more.
Hello, 大家好，我是 Hanny。今天我们要来学习在法郎会用到一些实用英语。第一段对话的标题是 A hip look， 时髦的发型。Hip 当名词呢，有这个髋部的意思，可是在这边跟髋部没有关系，它是当形容词来描述是时髦的、流行的，意思就跟 stylish 很相近。stylish， stylish 它可以形容是流行的，或者是时髦、时尚的、优雅、有格调的。那么对话一开始呢，美发师就用这个发廊那个围布，我们要剪头发不是会围一条布吗？那个围布把它套在 Aubrey 的身上，问他是不是要弄跟上一次一样的发型。那么 Aubrey 这次想要换造型，他就把手机上的照片秀给美发师看。美发师认为长包脖发型不太适合 Aubrey 的脸型，建议说他剪精灵头会很好看，但显然呢会是一个很大的改变。 Aubrey 听完就决定还是跟平常一样好了。好，我们来看单字 wrap， 这个动词呢是指用什么绕着或者把它围紧包裹的意思。那么 obviously 这个副词表示显然、明显的。那么文中这个 hairdresser 我们也可以说 hairstylist， 用来指美发师、发型设计师。至于 bob 在这边是指包脖头，它是指 耳朵这边齐的那种短发，还有 pixie cut 是精灵头。什么精灵头呢？就是很短的女生发型，然后有点蛮像男生的造型的那一种。那很多大明星都会剪这种发型，会让人觉得很好看，可是很难招架。好，这个段落有一个重点，我们进入文法时间。我们来看这个重点。Feel like 可以表达想要，后面是接名词或动名词去表达说想要某物啊，想要做某事。那这个用法的主词通常是人，我们就来造两个例句。Do you feel like a walk? 你想要散步吗？I don't feel like talking to anyone. 我不想跟任何人讲话。好，那另外 feel 当连缀动词的时候，可以用 feel like 加名词去表达。这时候就看主词喽。如果主词是人 ，somebody feel like 加名词是说某人感觉像什么。例如 ，I feel like a fool. 我觉得自己像个傻瓜。好，那当主词是物品的话 ，something feel like 加名词则是表达某物品摸起来像什么。例如。The blouse feels like silk. 这件女装衬衫摸起来像是丝绸做的。好，接回到课文中。
Tony is sitting in a salon chair.
So I cut in a wash?
Yeah, I'd like to dye my hair as well.
Did you have a color in mind? Hang on, let me get the color chart.
I want to dye my hair gray. This one.
Okay. First, I'm going to test to make sure that you're not allergic to the dye. I'll apply a bit of the dye behind your ear. If there's no reaction, I'll bleach your hair and then apply the rest of the dye.
I'll leave everything in your capable hands.
So it's part two of our look at what's going on at the hair salon. Part two. Oh, someone's getting old, getting gray hair.
Oh,
I have a little bit of gray hair.
Who's getting old? Yeah. Are you getting old?
Well, we're all getting old every day, of course.
But
sometimes getting gray hair is a big deal for people. It might be something they really don't want. And maybe...Tony is in that situation. It says Tony is sitting in a salon chair. So just from that, we know that Tony is the customer. That's why he's sitting in the chair. The hairstylist or hairdresser will be the one cutting the hair. And so how do we begin the dialogue?
So the hairdresser says, so a cut and a wash? So it seems like he probably knows the hairdresser or he's come several times. And we'll see what else Tony wants to do this time. Maybe fix those gray hairs.
Absolutely. And so Tony says, yeah, a hair, a wash and a cut. I definitely want that. But that's not the only thing Tony is there for today. He says, yeah.Wash and cut. I'd like to dye my hair as well. To dye or to color your hair, to change the natural color of your hair to something else. And yeah, right, when sometimes people start to get those gray hairs, they don't want to start to look old, so they get their hair dyed to match the rest of their younger looking hair.
So the hairdresser says, did you have a color in mind? Hang on, let me get the color chart. So there's a color chart with all these fake hairs, and it shows you what your hair will look like after it's dyed, and then you can match it to your head and then have a good idea of what you want to choose. The hairdresser shows Tony a hair color chart. Which one do you want, Tony?
That's weird, because I would think he would just want to match...his brown or black hair or something. Anyway, so Tony says, I want to dye my hair gray.
Okay,
this is very different from what I thought. He's not old, he might be young. He just wants to have gray hair.
It's cool, it's a style.
I see, very interesting. So blue hair, green hair, brown hair, pink hair, gray hair.As you say, it's a style. That's what he's going for. He wants to be young and cool with gray hair, not old looking young without gray hair.
Anyway, so
he's looking at all these colors, and yes, there might be the normal brown, black, you know, blonde, kind of yellow. There might also be pink, green, and blue, but there's also gray, and that is probably the color that he points at. This one, he says, pointing at the little piece of gray hair there. Interesting.
So the hairdresser says, okay, first I'm going to test to make sure that you're not allergic to the dye. So because these are chemicals, some people have a weird skin reaction or scalp reaction. Ooh. So there needs to be some tests to make sure this dye is fitting to the person. So hairstylist said, the hairdresser says, I'll apply a bit of the dye behind your ear where it's a sensitive area. If there's no reaction, I'll bleach your hair and then apply the rest of the dye. So actually dyeing it gray is very hard. You have to bleach it many times.
I see. So you have to make your hair kind of white.
Super white.
Before making it a color. Yeah, I guess that makes sense. Yeah. You can't really go from black to something lighter.
Yeah. I think Tony probably has like dark hair too.
Right, right.
So you have to bleach it like 4 or 5 times or something.
Interesting. Yeah, I've never done that. So it sounds like this is going to take some time.
Yeah.
But you're right. It's very good to be careful that the chemicals, the dye that they use, doesn't end up hurting your skin and causing all sorts of trouble you don't want. Well, Tony, he seems to be quite comfortable. He's been at this hairdresser many times. He knows the hairdresser is very skilled or very capable, as he says. I'll leave everything in your capable hands. This is basically when you trust someone to do a good job. I'm not worried. If you know what you're doing, and I think you do, go ahead, do what you do. I'll just read my magazine and wait to have my wonderful gray hair. Anyways, let's talk about this word reaction. A reaction is the effect of something or the response of something, often something that happens quite quickly, right? If I say something funny, your reaction might be to start laughing. If I tell you I have bad news, your reaction might be to get worried and say, oh no, what's going on? Or it could be a physical reaction, right? If you get pepper up your nose, your reaction might be to achoo, might be to sneeze. Or if I throw something at you, your reaction might be to catch it or put your hands up or something like that. So it's basically the B after A happens. For example, Charles had a bad reaction to the medicine, so he had to stop taking it. He took some medicine and then his body didn't like it. Maybe he got hot or his face turned red or he got really itchy or something like that. That's a bad reaction you don't want to have.
Ew, and the hairdresser, Tony believes, is very capable. Mm. When somebody is capable, that means they're really, really good at their job. They're really able to do a wonderful job and you don't have to worry about them at all. So of course, when you're doing something that's like having to do with your hair, your skin, your body, you need to rely on a capable person so that you can just like chill out and, like Mike said, you can just wait for your beautiful hair. Okay, I have an example sentence for you. I'm not worried about losing the case because I have a very capable lawyer. This is something that actually happened to me, and it feels so good to have a capable lawyer help you, because as a person who's not a lawyer, you don't really know so much about all the details all the time, and when somebody's very capable, you can trust them because you know they'll do the best job that's the best for you. So knowing capable people is super important.
That's right. And of course, the word skilled is a very similar word, S-K-I-L-L-E-D. Yes, so if you're getting your hair done, especially something like changing it from a natural brown to gray, make sure your hairdresser is capable and skilled. All right, well, that's all the time we have for today. We hope you have a wonderful trip to the hair salon. Whatever you decide to do, a simple wash or cut, or get your hair done like Billie Eilish and have it all sorts of colors. Good luck, enjoy, and I'm sure you'll be a more wonderful you than you already are. All right, take care, and we'll see you back here soon. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Tony 坐在发廊椅子上，他想要染头发，美发师呢就拿色卡给他看。Tony 说他想要把头发染成灰色，哎，哇，染这个颜色头发一定要先漂过，不知道要漂几次才会上色。那美发师就说呢，他会先在 Tony 耳后涂一点染料来测试一下，看看会不会对这个染料过敏。如果没有不良反应，就会帮他把头发漂成浅色，然后再上剩下的染料。Tony 接着回答说 I'll leave everything in your capable hands. 我把一切都交给你处理了。那么 capable 就是形容是有能力的、能干的。那么 in somebody's capable hands 表示由某人来处理。好 ，Mike 老师刚刚他用到 skilled 这个字，就是 skill 技巧后面加上 ed， 可以变成形容词来描述是熟练的、有技能的。再下一个单字 reaction， 它可以指反应、回应，那也可以用来指像是可能对药物、食物等等的不良反应、过敏反应等等。好，如果是对染剂过敏，这个头皮啊有可能会发红发痒，我们就补充一下，头皮的英文是 scalp， S C A L P， 还有 itchy 这个字是形容发痒的 ，I T C H Y。好，那我们再补充两个比较特别的颜色哦，一个是 blonde， 它可能会拼作 B L O N D 或是 B L O N D E， blonde 就是金发的，还有 neon green 则是指荧光绿，这个 neon 是拼作 N E O N。好，以上是今天的讲解，同学们别走开，马上回来哦。
A hairdresser wraps a salon cape around Aubrey.
Same as last time?
I liked what you did last time, but I feel like doing something different.
Nice! It's just that a long bob cut might not be right for your face shape.I think a pixie cut would look good on you, but it would be a big change, obviously.
I'm not sure if I'm ready for something like that. Maybe I'll just get the usual today.
Of course.
Tony is sitting in a salon chair.
So I cut in a wash?
Yeah, I'd like to dye my hair as well.
Did you have a color in mind? Hang on, let me get the color chart.
I want to dye my hair gray. This one.
Okay. First, I'm going to test to make sure that you're not allergic to the dye. I'll apply a bit of the dye behind your ear. If there's no reaction, I'll bleach your hair and then apply the rest of the dye.
I'll leave everything in your capable hands.
Taitung Art Museum is the first county art museum in Taiwan. It was opened in 1996 as a place for the people of Taitung to display, appreciate, create, and learn about art. The two major exhibition halls are called Song of the Mountains and Dance of the Sea, in keeping with the museum's overall theme of nature. The halls were constructed by a Japanese company.Both Japanese and local Aboriginal style architecture went into their creation. This building has a modern design that allows Taitung's amazing scenery to be reflected in the steel and glass. The art park outside holds a variety of landscape art. There are sculptures, tree houses, wooden paths, fountains, and pools.The museum is in central Taitung and is free to enter. It's an amazing place for people to relax.
See you next time!